Welcome to the breakout session, Intro to Advanced Authentication as a Service. Hello, my name is Kent Purdy, and with me I have Troy Drury, Senior Product Manager for the Access Management Products and the Product Manager for Advanced Authentication as a Service. Today we're going to go over a little bit about why we're doing Advanced Authentication as a Service and what it is. So with that, let's get started.
Okay, thank you, Kent. First, we're going to break down how, or maybe some categories, if you will, of how SaaS is thought about in our team. So, from a technical perspective, this is a little technical. It doesn't go into a deep dive, but it does give you enough of a feel for it. AA SaaS is in AWS. We currently have two U.S. regions. We have U.S. East and Ohio, U.S. East and Northern Virginia. And we plan on adding other U.S. regions as well as other worldwide regions as we go. I included Google and Azure on here just as a reminder that both of these are also on our roadmap. And when demand takes us in that direction, we will provide AA SaaS in those platforms as well. Okay. AA SaaS uses the same Docker Hub. So if you're familiar with AA on-prem, then you are familiar with AA SaaS, the same product, same Docker Hub. The difference here that you might find is that AA SaaS will move a little faster than AA on-prem when it comes to updates. As a feature is available, it'll be published into the cloud. And then on a three-month basis, we plan on rolling up all the features that have been published in the cloud into a release for on-prem. So every 3 months, we'll do a level set. The products will come back together and be exactly identical. But in between, what you find in the cloud might be a little bit ahead.
And that's a little bit unique, right? The fact that your SaaS offering, Troy, is the complete solution, but it's just simply offered as a service. It's not a broken out service. It's the entire product solution set. That is different in the market.
It's a big differentiator in the market because we didn't think that we should just force our customers into some abbreviated or less functional product. So we do have all the features that you find on-prem are available in SaaS as long as they work in SaaS. Some things just don't work in SaaS, and we'll bang into one of them here in just a second. It's Radius. We'll use the Cloud Bridge, which is actually an identity governance tool. It's been around for years. It's been updated. We'll use a Cloud Bridge to sync and a directory, whether that's AD or some other directory. We'll use it to sync the directory up to Advanced Authentication. So there is an on-prem component. Furthermore, we'll also have to have a Radius component on-prem. Now that Radius can be Microsoft MPS, or it can be our Radius agent. So either one of those will work as a Radius component, but AWS restricts direct Radius calls into the cloud. So we need to have a third party entity pushing them in a different fashion. So a Radius server communications back just through WebSockets works fine. We also will do auto scaling. So if customers find that they have peak times, it's not a problem. We can scale up. Today, we scale up pod by pod. Advanced Authentication is a single pod. We will be breaking these out into separate machines so that we'll be able to scale up based on a separate machine. If you look back on the recording, you'll see that the Docker Hub has about 19 different microtasks or machines in it, if you want to think of them that way. And then we'll be able to just provide another component, such as another database or another AU core product. We still support all the workstations that we supported before. You just have to have the agent on them the same way you did before. No change. It's identical to the on-prem component. AA SaaS comes with 100 data credits per user. So every user can use SMS or can use a voice call to their phones for authentication every month at no charge. Once they go over that 100, we start charging. It's about 1.5 cents per call. So it's very inexpensive. And 100 is big in the marketplace. Most of the other providers only give you about 60 a month. So we've upped the scale there a little bit as well. And our Center of Excellence provides end-to-end white glove onboarding. What that means is they'll be there to take a customer through every single piece of this. One reason for the white glove onboarding is because there are a couple tricky pieces when you come to having an on-prem component that needs to talk back into the cloud. You know, that's just not something you do every day. So it's a little tricky. And a Center of Excellence is there to help you through the whole process. So what are the functional advantages? AA SaaS provides a light to zero. I say light to zero because we all saw that you may need a Radius server. And if your repository of users is on your local premise, then you'll need the CloudBridge. So that's a light hardware solution for your on-prem to zero. And I'll show you in a minute how zero might work for you. The big advantage is it's the same framework. It's still the same architecture, providing the same expanded capabilities. And every month we strive to add new authenticators and new features that are very meaningful. And most of them, just to be honest, come from you, the customers, and from our partners. So this is still the same framework. We'll treat it the same way, and it'll get the same care and updates, speedy updates as we give out today. Something to remember, we don't use the internal Radius server. I already mentioned that. Doesn't exist in AWS traffic, so we have to use an external Radius provider. AA still supports multiple repos via the CloudBridge, so you can have an E directory, an Active Directory, and some other LDAP directory, even a SCIM directory. So pick your SQL type directory or whatever you want to use. You can still have multiple directories hooked up to Advanced Authentication the same way you did on-prem. There's no difference there. AA supports the same methods. There are a couple exceptions because they just can't work through the cloud, but for the most part, all the methods that you've been used to will be provided through AA as a service. Has the same feature set, provides the same workstation support. All three of these last ones, it's exactly the same. If you're using the same Docker containers to provide the same service, then of course you're going to get the same functionality. AA as a service includes the risk service. So the same way as your on-prem did, you get the risk service included. All right, operationally, there's some things that are a little different. I wanted to draw you a picture here and kind of give you a close idea of how things work. So the first three part numbers are ones that there's no charge for, but they need to be kept in mind. A trial is what we do when a customer needs to do more than a demonstration. We can do a demonstration today, any of the SEs can, and prove a customer's use case most of the time. When we can't do that and a customer wants to take it offline, work with their own data, maybe work with their own type of VPN or whatever they want to do, you can do a 30-day trial. And the trial is a no-cost trial. It's a 30-day trial. AA Limited is still available to our customers that have a product that qualifies for Advanced Authentication Limited. Now, today, AA Limited, for most purposes, lives on-prem. So if you have an on-prem product, such as Access Manager, then you are entitled to AA Limited on-prem. If you have a cloud qualifying product, such as Identity Governance SaaS, is entitled to Advanced Authentication Limited SaaS. So they go together. If you have SaaS product that is entitled, then you get the SaaS version of AA. If you have a on-prem, then you get the on-prem version of AA Limited. Advanced Authentication is broken down here. 854 and 855 part numbers, 6854, 6855. Those are the two base products, if you will. One of them is just multi-factor authentication, and one of them is multi-factor authentication with risk. You could think of this as the same model that you see in the competitors. The competitors sell a lightweight, thin, I would say less expensive MFA only product, and they sell it with risk and other plugins. So we've chosen the same model here. So MFA is that it's just MFA. It's just the methods. And of course, 6855 includes the risk service.
I think it might be worth mentioning, Troy, that if you subscribe to the Intercept plugin with the risk service, that's also SaaS-based. And so your entire solution would continue to be out in the cloud, which is pretty handy.
It is, absolutely. So if we go further down the list here, 6856 or AB809, if you want to think of it that way, it's identity proofing. It's a product that comes out later this year. We just went ahead and had the part number made. I wanted to tell you what it is so you don't go and sell it because it's not available yet. It'll be available actually around October. Advanced Authentication Client Components, you guys are familiar with those. This is just the SaaS version of those. It's no different. It's the same client. It's just we track things differently when it comes to budgetary stuff. And Advanced Authentication Data Credits are, like I mentioned before, user gets 100, but then if they go over, the company, the customer, starts to get charged for those extra ones. And the way they get charged is per 1,000. So if a customer goes over by 2,520 for their whole corporation, then they need to buy three of these Advanced Authentication SaaS data credit packs for that month. This is all consumption model, remember, so it is month by month. And then the next month, it's all reset. There is no rollover. So it just resets back to zero, and then they go on to the next month and they'll have another calculation. Monthly yearly pricing is in the works. I know you guys are already thinking about that. So it's consumption based today, but monthly and yearly pricing are in the works. Has a risk, has a MFA and a MFA plus risk models. So as I mentioned, you could think of it as a base model that's just MFA, and then you could think of it as an add-on is the risk. AA SaaS has the ability to for your customer to use AA clients as well. And that is an add-on piece. We just went over that. So it's a little more expensive. It's a 75 cents per user. AA SaaS includes the 100 data credits that I talked about and the option to purchase more. The identity proofing piece will come later. Okay. A high-level architecture of advanced authentication. Kind of drew a line in the sand here. I'm going to show you what lives above the line in the cloud and what lives below the line on-prem still. So you still have AA. We just moved it to AWS in the cloud. You still have to connect a directory, and I showed you before that that connection is through CloudBridge. You still can connect multiple directories if you want to. That works just fine. You may have a need for a Radius piece. And if you do have a need for a Radius piece, if it's a Microsoft shop, you can simply turn on the Microsoft MPS role on one of the servers, and that can work as your Radius piece. Or if it's not, or if they don't want to turn on MPS, you can use our Radius agent to talk back to AA. Also, this model is all Docker. So for updates, this can all be automatically updated. There's very little in the way of administrative overhead for updating these components. So Docker is a big advantage for us here as well. Looking at this model, what's missing? Of course, what's missing is Azure. CloudBridge can talk to Azure. So now you have a way to use an Azure database inside of advanced authentication. Well, if we look at this though, this still, what about clients that don't like to have things on-prem? There may be a newer company and everything they have is in SaaS. Well, that's okay, because we have this little thing called infrastructure as a service, and you can put both the CloudBridge and the Radius agents in that infrastructure as a service, and you can also connect your Azure database in the background or any other LDAP type of database you might be using in the background in the CloudBridge and use it that way. So this gives you, the second option gives you a fully cloud-based option. So there's two different ways that you can connect this way, with on-prem pieces or with all cloud. Points to remember here, it's the same Docker Hub. We said that several times. You get the same product. Docker is a big advantage for us because it reduces any administrative requirements around maintenance. CloudBridge has two components. I haven't mentioned that really before, but there's a CloudBridge agent and a CloudBridge client. The agent lives on-prem or in a cloud. Generally, it lives closer to the customer's databases, their repositories, if you will. And the CloudBridge client is the piece that lives in our facility and does the actual syncing back and forth with the CloudBridge agent. CloudBridge is multi-home. You can use multiple databases to it. CloudBridge also is bi-directional. That is a unique piece for us. Not only can we receive information, but we can push information out through CloudBridge. Also, and I didn't put it here, but CloudBridge supports identity governance, and CloudBridge will support other IaaS products as they come online. We have in the past done a pretty awful job of making our customers set up multiple password filters, multiple CloudBridges, multiple everything. Anytime they needed a new product, it came with some extra baggage that they had to set up on-prem. Now, since we're doing this new thing in the cloud, now we can fix that and do it the right way. CloudBridge is a universal tool. Also, the last note here is that NPS provides Radius, or you can use our Radius agent. In most cases, we'll look to NPS because most people are in a Microsoft shop. This is the same eye chart, periodic table, whichever you want to call it, that you've seen for a while. You can see that it continues to grow and that the methods are more and more and more and more features and more client components and even a column now for risk service on the side. So this will continue to grow, not only through these different squares at the top, but we continue to add a different standards that we follow along the bottom. Please don't try to memorize this. Just use it as reference.